So here's what the Gibeonites said. They said to David, he said, how can I make this right? And they said to David, the only way that you can make us right is we don't want your gold. We don't want your silver. We want your children. We want the children of Saul. He said, well, you're not getting Mephibosheth. And he said, I will give you those that were guilty of the murder. But you're not getting the rest of them. But even then, he said, there is something wrong here. And I don't exactly know how to explain to you why David didn't see it at that time. But the Gibeonites did not want any gold or silver. They wanted children. Here's the thing. I want you to understand the devil wants your children that he might eat them up and spit them out. He wants to destroy our kids because he knows if he can reach our children, he can change the future. But again, I want to tell you something. If we can reach our children, we can change the future as well. Amen. When we tell our kids that they're pretty special indeed, when we tell them that we're not ashamed of them and they're not ashamed of us, why, that's glory all around. Amen. It'll cause a church to come alive. It'll call the church to be a place where God's Spirit is welcome. Amen. Amen. So here she is up on the mountain, and the devil said, give us your sons and daughters. But the spirit of Rizpah begins to stir in some of our hearts. Amen. I like that. We begin to rise to the challenge and we say, no, no, no. Our children is our future, and I'm going to fight for them. We need to have a Rizpah revival. Amen. Let me expose Satan here. Let me tell you how he does things and show how he gets into the church. And he begins to cut and slice and dice and hang us out to die. Let me show you how the sorry Gibeon spirit, rat face, does things in people's lives. Because the Gibeonites are after us, but that isn't the end of it. I'm going to come back to the end of it in a moment. The Gibeonites said, we don't want your money. We don't want your gold. We want your children. But Rizpah, she was following them up the hill. She stayed in hiding for a little while until they left the bones there and the bodies there to be defiled by the animals. But it began to fill her memory, the last memory of their faces, her own children, her own relatives. Michael cried for a day or two, then she just forgot about it, but not the spirit of Rizpah. They took those boys up to the top of the mountain, and a little old woman followed them up there. When they dumped the old wagon out, they dumped it over, straightened it back up. It was the intent of the Gibeonites to have these sons of Saul ripped apart by the vultures and the wild beasts. There's a whole pile of bone and skin. And that little old woman got her sackcloth, got her out there on the stone, staring at the lifeless bodies on a rocky hillside. And her feeling was down on the inside. Oh, oh my God, not my babies. Not my babies, not my sons, not my daughters. They are mine. They belong to me. But God, would you please come and save our children? I can see a vulture drifting out of the hot thermals, rising above the cliffs, and he's eyeing the bones on the stone below, and the spirit of Rizpah tracked its flight. Rizpah was looking up and said, you come down here, and me and you are going to have a round. She's reaching around for a stick as that vulture comes down, and there she gets up, waving her sackcloth in one hand, and she's got a sword or a stick in the other. And she said, you're not going to have my children. I'm going to stand and watch over their bones. I'm going to keep their bones here, and you will not defile them. The church needs to have some strong bone on the inside. Amen. You're not going to get my kids. She spread out a sackcloth bed, determined to make the crags of the hot desert her new home. And with sleeplessness and burning eyeballs day and night, she would fight off the beast. No, no, no. I haven't rest. Can't rest. But I heard the sound of the lion as the lion was coming up the cliff. And there she goes. I have no weapons. All I have is a sackcloth and my little stick. And the lion comes and she says, you're not going to have the bones of my baby. You're not going to have them. It's me and you, and we'll go around. And if I die, I die fighting for the Lord God Almighty. Amen. Then when the shadows of twilight came in the nighttime, She heard the howl of the jackal, and she get back up. I can't rest right now, because I hear the sound of the howl of the jackal. No, you're not getting my kids. Let me tell you something. When the devil stole your daughter, when he stole your little girl, when he stole your little boy, when he takes your family, you'll get back to waving the sackcloth again and praying out to God, Father, we need you. We're feeding our kids to the lion. We're feeding our kids to the jackals. And nobody here's to fight off the horrible hyena dog that is stalking them every day. Nobody's here to fight the jackals on the internet. Nobody is here to fight that drug that goes down their body. The spirit of the Gibeonites will laugh and say, you saved others, but your own you couldn't save. But that didn't work for Rizpah. She said, I'm just an old woman, and all I have is my sackcloth and my stick, but I'm going to stay here, and the bones are going to be all right. But all of a sudden, a traveler came by and saw Rizpah, and Rizpah was on her knees trying to fight off the jackals and trying to fight off the lion and trying to fight off the buzzard and the dead. And the messenger said, what are you doing, Rizpah? And Rizpah says, I must protect the bones of Saul's children. I must protect the bones. I've got to keep the bones from being defiled. And the messenger said, how long have you been here? She said, I've been here since the harvest, and now it's beginning to rain all of this time, and I'm tired. But the messenger didn't stop there. He went to the king's house, and he said to David, do you know what Rizpah's doing? He said, no. Where is Rizpah? He's up on the mountaintop, and she's protecting the bones of Saul. What are you going to do? He said, get my chariot. She has the attention of the king, and I'm going to go. She has the attention of the king, and I get the chariot. I'll take the bones, and nobody will touch the bones again.
Amen. Amen.